the steel pans behind me, the orchestra playing. Ed Sheeran's about to come on. There's going to be another rendition of the national anthem, but this is drawing to a close. Well, joining me now are the royal commentator Victoria Howard, who writes for the Crown Chronicles website, and Charles Anson, who's a former press secretary to the Queen. Charles Anson, it is an extraordinary finale. What do you think the Queen will have made of it all?
I think the Queen will have been very touched by the massive flow of affection and admiration for the role she's played over 70 years. And when you look at the Silver Jubilee, it was more the Queen thanking people for supporting her. And I think the feeling of this Jubilee is everyone wanting to thank the Queen for her steady duty and her presence on the throne in all our lives in such a hugely changing society.
Yeah. I mean, just a few minutes ago, the crowds were let in from the Mall and they ran here. You maybe saw it.
Right.
They just ran here to get a decent place. We've got the gospel choir singing in the background now.
Right.
But the enthusiasm hasn't been shared by everyone across the country, has it? I mean, notably in Scotland, there's been some very sparsely attended events.
Well, I think in Scotland, often the Scots have a sort of undemonstrative way of showing it. In fact, they are very pro-monarchy on the whole. So I think the enthusiasm's there, and certainly nationally, as I've seen it, there is this very strong sense of affection. Even if you're not a monarchist, this is a head of state who's steadily kept going.
Victoria Howard, your highlights. I mean, Paddington Bear having tea with the Queen.
I absolutely think that is my highlight. You know, you have to reflect as well. In 1952, the Queen was doing her Christmas broadcasts on the radio. And in 2022, she's now interacting with a CGI bear to mark her Platinum Jubilee. So I think it just reflects the changing nature of the monarchy and how actually times have changed. And she's overseen all of that. But I think that will go down almost quite as well as the James Bond sketch from 2012.
Charles Anson, last night we saw a vision of the future of the monarchy. We had Prince Charles, Prince William on stage at the party. They got a very warm reception, but it's hard to imagine Charles having tea with Paddington Bear, isn't it?
I don't think it is. I think he's got a sense of humour and enjoys these occasions when they involve young people and all sorts of people from different backgrounds. And that way, I think he's a very modern prince and will be a very modern king. So I think it's good.
Victoria Howard, is it the case that the next generation is going to have to reform the monarchy?
So the monarchy has to move with the times to stay relevant. So Prince Charles has always talked about a slimmed down version of the monarchy, fewer royals doing more engagements to give better value for money. And I think we will see a shift in the way the monarchy operates in that way. They will do bigger causes with fewer organisations to make a bigger impact to give that value. And I do think we're going to see, obviously, the Queen's cousins stopping with their duties. They are in their 80s now.
But, you know, it's all very well, all this razzmatazz and everybody having a party and so on. Great. But actually, the monarchy is still incredibly distant from people in the middle of a cost of living crisis. Not in touch, really, are they?
That is definitely an argument, I think. But, of course, this was done in consultation with the government, who think the economic benefit in particular is very worth it. So I think that we do have to take that into consideration. But there is a bit of a veil of mystique, and that is kind of what keeps the monarchy going, because we don't want them to be exactly like us.
You know, we're in front of this most magnificent palace here. This has been billed as the people's pageant. But can there ever be a people's monarchy?
Well, I think the great strength of the British monarchy is that it's always been ready to adapt and change. And although the Queen stays immutably the same in terms of her devotion to public duty, she's very open to widening the monarchy to the population and to the public. And I think one of the ways that she's done it very successfully is to preside over the Commonwealth and make of society in this country a much more multi-ethnic heritage, and that is reflected at garden parties and public engagements and encouragement generally.
Well, you know, politicians divide the country. You know, inevitably, you know, you either support one party or another, generally. Boris Johnson was booed outside the St. Paul's Thanksgiving service. Has this united us in some ways?
I think so. In the sort of post-pandemic world, if we can call it that, I think we all needed a moment to try and come together. And I think this has provided that opportunity. So people not only saying thank you, but kind of admitting they've got a little soft spot for the Queen and recognising the dedication of 7 decades, I think that is quite significant.